The Hanoverian School of Architecture refers to a school of historicist architecture of the second half of the 19th century that was predominantly widespread in northern Germany. It is characterized by a departure from classicism and neo-baroque and a turn towards neo-Gothic. Its founder, the architect Conrad Wilhelm Hayes, created almost 80 new churches and over 60 secular buildings. In addition, Hayes taught at the Polytechnic University in Hanover for 45 years and during this time trained around 1,000 full architects, many of whom adopted his stylistic principles. Stylistically, these buildings were characterized by their unrendered brick facades, which was perceived as honest. It was especially true for factory buildings that the outer form of a building should already reveal its inner function. A number of design elements were used to decorate the exterior of the buildings. For example, corner gables taken over from medieval church construction, molded bricks and decoratively set bricks with glazed surfaces. The Hanoverian school was preceded by the phase of the round arch style, which lasted from about 1835 to 1865. This movement was also a manifestation of historicism, i.e., a taking up and recombining of elements of older styles. The Hanoverian form of the round arch style spread not only in the city itself, but also in the Kingdom of Hanover. Two expressions can be distinguished here: the Traum style developed by court architect Christian Heinrich Traum, characterized by stickwork and corner stick turrets, and the style founded by city architect August Heinrich Andrea, with bricks used in a plastic spatial manner. Conrad Wilhelm Hayes's building activities became the driving force behind the Hanoverian school. In addition, Hayes taught at the Technical University in Hanover and thus also ensured the dissemination of his ideas. From 1849 to 1894, his teaching activities there included the subjects of designing public and private buildings, higher architecture, the theory of forms in medieval architecture, and ornamentation. In his work, Hayes strove to break away from the classicist architectural style represented by Georg Ludwig Friedrich Laves and from the neo-baroque tendencies adopted from France in favor of medieval forms, which he regarded as stylistically pure. The Hanoverian education in architecture enjoyed superregional recognition, so that students came from all parts of northern Germany, as well as from North and South America, England, the Netherlands, and especially Norway. The visible use of bricks for facade facing played a decisive role in the Hanover school. The brick measure determined the design of the walls and ensured uniform horizontal layering. The joints appearing between the brick structure of the building, all surfaces, friezes, columns can be divided into a certain number of brick courses. In order to decorate the buildings with decorative details, architects and masons had numerous means at their disposal. They used shaped bricks or made use of polychrome colored bricks on a facade, for example, in red and yellow. In addition, glazed bricks in different colors were used, for example, in brown, black and green. Particularly numerous and distinctive decorative elements adorn the magnificent villas, but also in the usual housing construction occurred numerous details that are often only visible at second glance. The buildings received extensive ornamental fields and colored glazed bricks contrasting with the rest of the wall. With three-dimensional tendrils in the ornamental fields, the Art Nouveau style was already in evidence. Why are no more people-friendly quarters being built today as they were in the centuries before modernism? Today's buildings are often hostile to people, cold and uncharitable. Traditional forms or ornaments are no longer used by architects. Everything is rasterized mercilessly down. It arises clinically cold streets, real inhospitable places, this not only in Germany but everywhere in the Western world. Commit yourselves like me for a more beautiful cityscape. Thank you for every like. Thank you. If you like my videos, then subscribe to my channel here to see my latest videos. If you want to see another video directly, then click here. Interesting videos can also be found here.